Hello everyone, in this video session I am going to explain part 177 of Java for Tester series, that is modifiers. So what are modifiers? Modifiers in Java are few predefined keywords. Okay, modifiers in Java are few predefined keywords which can be used with variables. These modifiers can be used with variables, methods, constructors, and classes. Okay, these modifiers are few predefined keywords which can be used with variables, methods, constructors, and classes. So what will happen when I use these predefined keywords with these variables, methods, constructors, and classes in Java? They will modify the behavior or change the nature, change the working nature. So now understand guys, what exactly are the modifiers? Okay, these three statements will give an idea of what exactly the modifiers are. First of all, modifiers are few predefined keywords which can be used with variables, methods, constructors, and classes. On using these modifiers with the variables, methods, constructors, and classes, the original working of these variables, methods, constructors, and classes is going to get modified. The behavior of this variables, methods, constructors, and class is going to get modified, and also the working nature of these variables, methods, constructors, and classes is going to change. So those are nothing but modifiers, guys. So there are different modifiers in Java. In Java, there are different modifiers, guys. What are the different modifiers in Java? Modifiers in Java can be categorized into two types. Okay, modifiers in Java at a high level. Okay, I am just writing modifiers here. Modifiers in Java at a high level can be categorized into two types. One is access modifiers. Other one is non-access modifiers. So what are access modifiers and what are non-access modifiers? Okay, I'll explain that. And coming to access modifiers, we have four access modifiers, guys. Under access modifiers, we have four modifiers. They are, one is public, then we have private, then protected, and then default. Okay, these are the four modifiers which are under the access modifiers category of these modifiers. Okay, and these are all the keywords, guys. Okay, I told you, right? Modifiers are nothing but few predefined keywords. Here public is a predefined keyword, private is a predefined keyword, protected is a predefined keyword. But coming to the default, guys, okay, if you don't provide any keyword, okay, if you don't provide any keyword, then it is default, guys. There is no keyword, like there is no predefined keyword with the name default, guys. Okay, here public is a name, one predefined named keyword is public. Private also has a name, protected is also a name, but coming to default, okay, here there is no name, okay, no name for this keyword. If you don't provide any public, private, protected, it will become default. I'll explain you how to use this default thing in the upcoming videos anyhow. For now, understand that under access modifiers, we have four types, that is public, private, protected, and default. Coming to public, private, protected, these are the three keywords, guys. Okay, if you don't provide any of these three keywords, by default, it will become default, okay. By default, the modifier will be default, guys. If you don't provide these modifiers, then it is considered internally by Java as a default modifier, okay? Default access modifier, fine. So you don't have to provide this text default, guys. It doesn't exist, okay? If you don't provide this keywords, then it will become default internally. Internally, Java will treat that as default modifier, okay? If you don't provide any text. Now coming to the non-access modifiers, we have different non-access modifiers. Let's say there are six, okay? 3, 4, 5, and 6. Six non-access modifiers are there. So coming to the first one, that is static. Then we have final. Static, then final. Then we have something known as abstract. Then we have, what is that? Synchronized. Okay, transient. Volatile. Like this, there are six non-access modifiers. Okay, These are all the keywords, guys. These are predefined. These are few predefined keywords of Java, okay, which fall under the non-access modifier category of modifiers. So these are the different modifiers we have in Java, guys. Modifiers in Java can be categorized into two types, that is access modifiers and non-access modifiers. Okay, access modifiers can be further categorized into different keywords known as public, private, protected. Okay, if you don't provide this keyword, it will become default. Okay, then coming to the non-access modifiers, we have different predefined keywords like static, final, abstract, synchronize, transient, and volatile. Okay, this synchronize, transient, and volatile. So these are the six non-access modifiers, and these are the four access modifiers. So what is known as access modifiers and what is known as non-access modifiers? Coming to access modifiers are nothing but they modify or control the access. Okay, they modify the using this access modifiers, guys. We can modify the this access modifiers modify the access levels or controls of the variables, methods, constructors, and classes. Okay, when you use access modifiers with variables, methods, and constructors and classes, they modify their access levels or controls. Okay, so public has some access level, private has some access level, protected when used has some access level. Okay, so these variables, methods, and constructors and classes, okay, the access levels or controls of these variables, methods, and constructors and classes can be modified. Okay, the original variables, methods, constructors, classes will have their own access levels or controls, right? Using this access modifiers, we can modify those access levels or controls or permission levels. Okay, anyhow, I'll explain how to use this access modifiers in the upcoming videos. For now, understand that what are access modifiers. Using access modifiers, we can modify or change the access levels or controls of these variables, methods, constructors, and classes. Coming to non-access modifiers, as the name suggests, they are non-access modifiers. Okay, they are not related to access levels. Not related to access levels or controls. They don't change any access levels or controls, guys, because these are non-access modifiers. Coming to access modifiers, they modify the access levels or controls of the variables, methods, constructors, and classes. But coming to the non-access modifiers, they are not related to access levels or controls. They will not do anything about this access. Okay, but they modify the this non-access modifiers modify the behavior or change the working nature by providing special qualities. Okay, special properties, you can say. To what, guys? Okay, when you use non-access modifiers, they modify the behavior or change the working nature by providing special properties to variables, methods, constructors, and classes. Okay, so when you apply the non-access access modifiers, they deal with the access levels or permissions or controls of the variables, methods, constructors, and classes. But coming to the non-access, they are not related to the access levels or control, guys. Okay, they will not do anything about access levels or controls of the variables, methods, constructors, and classes. But non-access modifiers will change the behavior, okay, of these variables, methods, constructors, and classes. They will modify the behavior or change the working nature of these variables, methods, constructors, and classes by providing some special properties to these variables, methods, constructors, and classes. Okay. So both are different, guys. Modifiers are categorized to access modifiers and non-access modifiers. Access modifiers are related to the access permissions and levels or controls. They modify those things. Whereas coming to non-access modifiers, they modify the behavior or working nature of this variables, methods, constructors, and classes. Okay. So guys, this is all about the modifiers, guys. Okay. This is all about the modifiers. We are going to continue a lot of videos on this modifiers topic. Because there are different modifiers like access modifiers and non-access modifiers. In the coming videos, I'll explain each and every access modifier and each and every non-access modifier. Okay, I'll explain each and every access modifier and each and every non-access modifiers in detail in the upcoming videos, guys. So let's continue the modifiers topics in the upcoming videos, guys. So in the next video session, I'm going to explain public access modifier. Okay, how to use the first access modifier, that is this public access modifier I'm going to explain as part of the next video session, guys. So that's it, guys. See you in the next video session. Thank you. Bye.